Larry? No. Steve? No. Oh, hey, scientist. I'm trying to think of a name for my new pet. Do you want to meet them? Here it is. My new pet cactus. Isn't it so sharp and planty? I thought having a pet would be cool, but even though this cactus is a living thing, it's not the same as a puppy or a turtle. Maybe I should have gotten an animal instead of a plant. But what is an animal? And how is an animal different from a plant? Animals are living things, just like plants, but they have their own special characteristics that set them apart. First, animals can move. While plants have roots that keep them stuck in one spot, animals move around on their own. In fact, most animals have to move in order to get themselves food and water, shelter, and protection. Not all animals move in the same way. Birds have wings, and many are able to fly. Some animals have two legs and walk upright. Other animals walk on four or six legs, or even more. Some animals' legs are bent in a special way to help them hop or jump from place to place. There are even animals without any legs at all. So instead, they use their muscles to move across the ground or their fins to swim in the water. No matter how they move, almost all animals are able to move around on their own. We can also set animals apart from other living things because they eat food. Unlike plants, animals are not able to use photosynthesis to make their own nutrients. So animals have to eat to get the energy they need to survive. There are animals that eat only meat, called carnivores. Taking the word apart, carne means meat and vor means to eat, so carnivore literally means meat eater. Lions, sharks, crocodiles, and owls are carnivores because they hunt other animals to get all of their food. Herbivores eat only plants like leaves, berries, and even tree bark. Koalas, caterpillars, elephants, and cows are all examples of herbivores. Omnivores are animals that eat both meat and plants. Bears, dogs, and chickens are all omnivores, and they're in good company because humans are considered omnivores too. We already know that all living things are able to grow and change, and we learned about how plants go through a specific life cycle that repeats over and over again. Well, guess what? Animals have a life cycle too. Different animals have different life cycles, but they always have four basic parts: birth, growth, reproduction, and death. When animals are born, they don't grow out of a seed like a plant does. Instead, animals either grow inside of an egg or inside of their mother's body. When the animal comes out of the egg or the mother, that is a stage called birth. The next stage, growth, is where the animal matures from a baby into an adult. In some cases, this stage lasts a long time, like how it can take years for a puppy to grow into a dog. In other animals, this happens through a much faster process called metamorphosis, where the animal seems to change completely in a short amount of time. A butterfly goes through metamorphosis. It starts as a caterpillar when it is born, and when it is ready to become an adult, it builds a chrysalis, or a hard case, to go inside. While inside the chrysalis, metamorphosis happens, and when it emerges, it is transformed into a beautiful butterfly. When animals are adults, they are able to reproduce. Remember, reproduction means making more of itself. So, when adult animals lay eggs or have babies inside of them, they're in the reproduction stage of their life cycles. Most animals are able to reproduce multiple times to keep the life cycle starting over and over again. Finally, the last stage in an animal's life cycle is death. Animals can't live forever, though how long they do live depends on the type of animal. The mayfly has the shortest life cycle of any animal, going through all of the stages from birth to death in a single day. A Greenland shark can live for up to 500 years. That's a long life cycle. Humans are animals whose life cycle lasts about 80 to 100 years. That's right. Humans are animals who go through this life cycle too. What stage of the animal life cycle are you in right now? So even though plants are living things, animals are unique because they move on their own, eat food, and have their own special life cycle. I guess that's why people don't usually get plants as pets. Oh. Still, it's important to remember that animals and plants are living things, so we need to take care of them and treat them with respect. I think I'll name you Mia number 2. Until next time, scientist, science is all around you. Hey, hey.